Well, good morning. In preparation for Hurricane Isaias, signed an executive order yesterday to declare a state of emergency in every coastal county up Florida's East Coast from Miami-Dade to Nassau County. I also sent a letter to President Trump requesting a federal disaster declaration. We just got word this morning that that has been approved and will contain reimbursement for direct federal assistance, as well as all the mass care. So the feeding and sheltering will be eligible for federal reimbursement through FEMA, which we very much appreciate. In addition to my order, the following 12 counties have declared a local state of emergency: Palm Beach, Monroe, Volusia, Osceola, Seminole, Brevard, Indian River, Martin, Orange, Okeechobee, Glades, and Flagler. Isaias is currently located in the central Bahamas and is traveling northwest at 12 miles per hour. Latest projections have Isaias coming very close to the east coast of Florida as a Category 1 hurricane later this evening and into tomorrow. They had yesterday was kind of a shift of the eye closer to Florida's coast. This morning, it's a little bit further north and off the coast in terms of the closest impact of the eye. Right now, they say is off coast, but this stuff is all very much in flux. And even if the eye of the storm stays off the coast, there of course is going to be impacts when you're talking about hurricane or tropical storm force winds. So folks need to be prepared for that. And if you're in an area in an evacuation zone and you do get those orders to evacuate, please heed that call. Hurricane warnings are in effect from Boca Raton to the Volusia-Flagler County line, and the National Hurricane Center is also predicting potential storm surge of 2 to 4 feet from Jupiter Inlet all the way up north to Ponte Vedra Beach. As I mentioned yesterday, the state of Florida is fully prepared for this. Some agency updates include the following: the Division of Emergency Management is sending 25 shelter kits with PPE to counties in the path of the storm. Each kit provides PPE for up to 400 people for 96 hours, and we can send more if necessary. We also, through ACA and the Department of Health, have been in contact with our hospitals. We don't anticipate hospitals needing to evacuate patients at this time. We have maybe one smaller hospital that is going to move some COVID patients to a different hospital in the area in Brevard County, but that's about the extent of it. But obviously, we stand ready to be able to assist in any efforts as they may develop. The division's also identifying pre-staging areas for power restoration crews and has already pre-staged 1.8 million meals. FDOT has mobilized pumps to respond to potential flooding. And the Florida Fish and Wildlife Conservation Commission has special operations groups members on standby to move into Hurricane Isaias impacted areas and support urban search and rescue teams if that were to be necessary. These groups have a lot of capacity: all-terrain vehicles, shallow draft vessels that will enhance the recon efforts. All FWC storm units will shelter in place and be ready to respond to assigned areas as weather conditions allow. Florida Highway Patrol is also closely monitoring the hurricane and stands ready to assist. Visit Florida's three official Florida Welcome Centers located at major access points in the state, transitioned into emergency information centers, offering the latest details on Hurricane Isaias. Most important thing we want people to do now is remain vigilant, pay close attention to the Weather Channel, to official updates at the state and local level. This is something that's an evolving situation. We know we are going to get some impacts. What shape those impacts take remains to be seen. We'll be looking at the, of course, the 11 a.m. advisory from the National Hurricane Center. There's a lot of, as we talked to the meteorologist, there's a lot of different, there's some dry air, some shear, and that has an effect on the course and the strength of this thing. So we want people to just be very cognizant that this thing is on the way. Obviously remain calm, but listen to the instructions as they come down. Everyone should at this point, who's in the potential path of this, have enough food, water, and medicine the last 7 days. If you haven't done that, you still have time to do it, but we really recommend that you finish those preparations immediately. Also, know whether you're in an evacuation zone. When you talk about some of this potential storm surge, those areas, barrier islands and the like, they're going to be the ones that are most likely affected by that. Also, some of the counties counties may be looking at folks who live in mobile homes. If you are closer to the coast, you may get evacuations from there. So just please take the time to determine what zone you're in. And if you are ordered to evacuate, please take it seriously and go. State of Florida has helped, and the counties have been involved in really having shelter options in an era of COVID-19. And so we have the non-congregate options available for people who may be experiencing COVID-19 symptoms. And a lot of that will be using hotels to be able to do that. And that has been something that's been prepared for. That has not been necessary up to this point. We'll see over the next 12 to 24 hours, whether that will be, but that is an option. And then of course, with the PPE and other things for some of the more traditional sheltering. And again, now that the disaster declaration has been approved, you do have the ability to get reimbursed for the food and the sheltering as the local community see fit. So we stand by to help those efforts as well. All Floridians can go to floridadisaster.org for information on disaster supply kits, evacuation zones, and the latest update regarding Hurricane Isaias. So appreciate everybody being vigilant during a really unique time in Florida's history. With that, take a couple questions.
I was curious if you had any comment on the head of the Florida prison system and his deputy coming down with COVID-19. And then we also heard about the death of a jailer in the prison system as well. Just curious if you wanted to weigh in on what the situation is in Florida's prisons with regards to COVID.
Well, the prisons have been a reflection of, as the prevalence has increased in the community, we've seen it increase with like the guards. There's been a lot of testing that's going on. There's been a lot of things that are done, to try to limit the spread within that system. But it's a difficult problem. But we really appreciate, I think, the folks who've been working in that, have really worked incredibly hard over the last really months, but certainly, the last 4 to 6 weeks, have been really trying. So we appreciate all the efforts that they're doing. It's not an easy situation when you're dealing with a prison setting. All right. Well, we're going to do another update probably about 5 o'clock. If there's any other updates in the meantime, we'll be sure to put it out for you guys.